Good afternoon. Welcome to the Mid Norfolk Garden. This afternoon I'm in the farmyard cottage garden and I'm going to be propagating some seeds of my hardy annuals and my perennials. So if you come with me, we'll just go and have a look at what we're going to do. Okay, it must be one of the hottest days of the year today and the garden is looking gorgeous in the sunshine. The climbing roses and the ramblers are looking at their absolute best. This is beautiful ones, absolutely covered in bees. And butterflies are here. We've got this absolutely beautiful honeysuckle as well. I'm not sure if I planted that or that just appeared. Okay, I'm just taking you through to the area that we're going to focus on today. Going through this beautiful rambling rose here. It's an absolutely incredible scent. Just going under the archway. And the area we're going to focus on today is this. This is a small area. We had an enormous pine tree here and the tree died a couple of years ago from honey fungus, and so now I have a patch of ground which is very poor soil, very nutrient depleted as the tree was quite old, and I noticed that there was some Oxe Eye Daisy coming up in it. So what I've decided to do, rather than trying to re-turf this or make it into a border, which is quite difficult, I've decided I'm going to make it into a flower meadow and I'm going to seed it with Oxe Eye Daisies. So I've been gradually seeding it over the last week, but I'm going to put more in. These little plants here are the baby Oxe Eye Daisies, and they will give us lots of flower next year. We may actually get some flower this autumn as well. I've started watering them as we've got a bit of a drought at the moment. I'm gradually taking the grass out. As you can see, there is, well, I've got a bit of company from the dog. As you can see, there is grass here amongst the Oxe Eye Daisies. So I'm gradually taking the grass out to give the Oxe Eye Daisies a better chance, because actually this is couch grass and it's quite tough stuff, and the Oxe Eye Daisies prefer less competition. Okay, this is the meadow, and I also want to seed the meadow with Oxe Eye Daisies. Earlier in the season this was a spectacular area of the garden that was absolutely full of spring bulbs, mainly daffodils and narcissi. But at this time of year we let it go to meadow. As you can hear, it's absolutely buzzing with insect life. We've got quite a few wildflowers coming in, but last year I seeded it quite heavily with Oxe Eye Daisy, but actually I have very few of them have come up, and I think it's because the grass is just too vigorous. So this year what I'm going to do, when the hay is cut later in the season, as you can see there are some really lovely wildflowers in it. What I'm going to do is scarify areas and seed that with the Oxe Eye Daisy, because then it will stand a better chance if there's less grass. And here are the Oxe Eye Daisies that I'm going to collect the seed from. They're actually right next to the meadow, and I was hoping that they would just naturally seed into the meadow, but that hasn't really happened. So I'm going to need to give them a bit of a helping hand. So the Oxe Eye Daisies have been absolutely spectacular this year. A real, you know, splash of colour, but they're over pretty much now. So we're going to collect the seed. I'm just trying to find a seed head with some seed, because I've already collected some. Let me have a quick look. Okay, this is what you're looking for. This is the mature seed pod here. Okay, so you just pop the head off, and you can, just to release the seed, just break it up in your hand, and there you can see the seeds. Okay, so you just want to spread these seeds where you want them to grow at this time of year, or you could save some seed for next year and then sow it in the spring. But because we're in Norfolk and it's a very good mild climate, I find that if I sow them at this time of year, I'm just going to sow those back into there, then I get a really good germination rate. Some of them will come up this season, some of them will germinate next spring. After you've collected the Oxe Eye Daisy seed, you can store it in a paper envelope or a paper bag ready for when you're going to use it. I'm going to sow some of it straight away, but this is just to show you that what the Oxe Eye Daisies look like. This is a plant that had already set seed. I'd cut it hard back and it's actually putting up another lot of flowers. So after you've collected your seed, if I go along this border where you can see the Oxe Eye Daisies are very much sort of over, once I've collected the seed and I cut them all back to the ground, I'll get another lovely flush of Oxe Eye Daisy, probably in about August or September. It won't be as magnificent as the first flush, but it's definitely worth having. And also it'll come into flower at a time of year when there isn't often that much flower. Okay, I've just come around here to collect some more seed, as I haven't collected the seed off this side. So I'll just collect the seed heads that have got the mature seed on, just by popping them off. I've got a lovely handful of seed, as you can see. And just pop that down now and put it in the area that I've prepared. Okay, well, I'm back at the area that I've prepared. It's about 5 metres by 5 metres. And as you can see, I've taken most of the grass out and just left the wildflowers in. I've actually got some other wildflowers coming up in here. I've got tansy here, which is a really tall yellow flower. I did actually dig an oxeye daisy up that was coming up in the wrong place, and I popped it in here. But actually, it's not doing nearly as well as the self-seeded ones. They do establish really well from seed. So I'm just going to scatter my seed, which I've got here. I'm just going to scatter it around where I want them, on the bare patches where I want them to come up. And then later on, I'll get my water and give them a good watering in. I might actually give it a little bit of a raking as well to help them settle in. But this time next year, I should have the most wonderful display of oxeye daisy. They usually flower in about May, June, so they'll probably be setting seed by July. I couldn't finish without showing you these wonderful roses that we've got on the trellis here. They're absolutely fantastic. They're at their best at the moment. I just wanted to show you them while they're in flower. They're not scented, but they are spectacular. Anyway, hope you enjoyed my video about how to make oxeye daisies. If you have any questions, please leave them in comments and I'll respond to them. Good luck. Hope you have lots of success with your self-seeded annuals and perennials. If you've enjoyed the video, please hit subscribe, like, comment and share. It would be really appreciated. And we'll be posting some more videos about collecting seed from the cottage garden over the next week or two. Thank you for watching. Bye.